the shared habitat of a young family and their feline friends.
Welcome to our Cat Cafe inspired house. We came to know about this book by Jackson Galaxy. He's also known as the Cat Whisperer. He believes in catifying the entire house, leaving the higher space for the cats to walk around so that they feel secured. We are pretty much inspired by Jackson Galaxy.
Creating a home fit for human and feline alike is no easy feat. Fortunately, Mike and Shuli found JQ Ong.
When I got an email from Shuli and Mike, it really caught my interest because they showed me a full array of images of cats living in a home. They have a few criteria they want to meet in the house. First is, of course, cat friendly. Second is, Mike needs an entertainment space and also a space for Ian to grow.
The overall effect is a symbiotic design that sees a raw, natural decor integrated with a jungle gym for cats.
We have a giant cat pole that runs from the floor all the way to the ceiling, and a giant catwalk in the living room. I'm really feeling sorry for them that they didn't have their own garden and grass pasture to go around. Yeah, so this is the best I could do for them.
There are perches and skywalks, all designed with the cat's ergonomics in mind.
I wanted to make sure that the cats have some challenges as well. Basically like climbing, going up slopes, jumping across a platform to another platform, you know, to make sure that they exercise. And that will keep the cat healthy and happy.
Plywood and hearth flooring were choice materials employed throughout the home for its simple yet chic aesthetic value as well as its practicality.
Basically, it's a high-resilient flooring that is waterproof. If the cat were to have some accidents, you can clean it easily and you know you don't have any issues with that.
So we like everything to be very natural, very raw, preferably without any finishes. That's why we decided on plywood for most of the housing fixtures. And it's also durable against cat scratches.
Keeping in line with the raw, natural feel of the home is the exposed conduit pipes and electrical outlets masked in black.
There's a theory that I always have when it comes to designing a house, is that things you cannot hide, you just make it louder.
We want it to be a house whereby we can accommodate a lot of people because we love to have party.
I want a huge table that can house everyone. It's like a buffet table. Everyone can sit at a table, and I believe that's where the conversation starts.
Anchoring the living room is a gorgeous oversized sofa designed by JQ. Upholstered with a mix of off-cut fabrics, it serves as a unique centerpiece for the home, as well as a highly adjustable modular seating system.
This sofa can customize to accommodate really a lot of people. So you can just spread out every single cushion and you can cover the whole living room. We love it.
For the master bathroom, we designed this sink so that you can actually you know, feed the cat in and they can bathe them properly. And also we provide hot water as well, so the cat will feel really comfortable.
I think the hierarchy in this house is the cat, my son Ian, then Shuli, then me.
Aw, Mike. We know this didn't stop you from carving out a space for yourself.
I always wanted a place where we can watch movies together as a family. I find that it's quite hard sometimes for a family just to spend time together because work is really occupying quite a lot of time. So being able to watch a movie together is quite happy and fun.
The result is an amazing mini theater equipped with a 92-inch projector screen and surround sound system.
JQ suggested that we can replace the blinds with the projector screen. By doing so, we are able to build the depth.
Even this cozy space is not without its unique touches, such as these shelves made out of plywood and bricks.
Friends and family who came over really like this house because it's like a cozy cat cafe for them.
For Shuli, her passion with cats is actually admirable. It's hard to find people who are so into caring for animals, putting them as even one of their top priorities, even for a home. That's admirable.
I'm not really a cat lover, I'm neutral. But I love my wife, so I love what she loves.
Clearly, at the heart of Mike and Shuli's cat house is an inspiring love story.
It's really what we dream of it. Definitely, I'm happy.